Hello everyone and welcome back to the Zephyr Modpack. It took me a while, but I finally got right. My mana drains during the rain. I got a rainy day. I had a couple rainy nights, but I have finally a rainy day. Fortunately, my mana is all gone. How can I fight? How do I do the command where I can see like attack details and everything? That I think it's F3H. F3A. Yeah. There we go. I don't know that I can actually kill this thing with conventional weaponry. I suppose we'll find out. We don't have much of a choice. Oh man, that is a lot of damage though. Ugh. No, I kind of need just a shelter to fight this thing in. Yep, because I can't kill this thing without lightning damage. Now. Ugh. Well, that's unfortunate, as it is now in my house. Oh yeah. Okay. I need it out of here. Oh my god, this is turning out to be a nightmare. Yep, and now I will die. And I will respawn. Oh my god, this is the worst. Alrighty. Ugh. Okay. So. We didn't quite account for everything. Well, I didn't quite account for everything, let's be honest here. Fortunate as this situation is. What options do I have? Finding it indoors is definitely to my benefit, even if the close quarters kind of make things a little risky. There we go. Just gotta get it over here. Oh my god. It does so much damage. My armor doesn't do a thing against this guy. Oh no, get that closed. Thank you. Depth's gonna be too big. There we go. Have so many of these markers here now. Okay, I still have a chance to beat it. Matter of fact, a hole in the wall might be my best chance to beat it. I wonder if it takes fall damage. Could I make it to the could I make it to the ladder from here? Oh, that's a curious idea. I mean, I doubt it, but what if? Did it work? Where'd it go? Did it fall down below? No. Did it despawn? Maybe. Okay, so what I learned is that if I want to do this fight, wait a minute. Why do I hear it? Oh, I bet I know what happened. Infinite loop. Okay, let's go ahead and I'm gonna relog here. It could be in the house, in which case I'm in a bad spot. Or could be over here. Okay, well, probably somewhere in here. Ow. Oh. It's not glamorous, but hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. Okay. The other hand. Ow. Okay. Okay, that worked. Oh, hold on. No, not you. Where did I leave my... Where did I leave my armor? That would explain why I'm dying so... In the very first one. Okay, yeah, no. That's cool. Oh, hello. Oh. So we did get his rare drop, which is lucky as all get out. I mean, that whole situation was lucky, but... I should probably just dig this up. So I lost a whole ton of levels there, but that's fine. The armor shouldn't have lost its levels, so these guys are at 20. Not too shabby. How's my Dark Ethereum coming along? 33%, not too shabby. Oof. Not always active, because I'm not always near it, but... Oh, you got switched. All right, let's get rid of all these markers. So that was interesting. Why are you not disappearing? Not harvestable. Okay, but the other ones were? Alright, hold on a minute. Move, remove, remove, remove. There we go. Break. Ugh. And rotate it all I want. Oh, that would be why. Huh. There we go. That would be why. And hold on, come to think of it, I had another one that I couldn't break before. Okay. Break. Alright, where was it? It was over here somewhere. Something killed me out here. Apparently I could break you all along. Alright, well, let's go over what we got from him. So, we got the water orbs, which I believe... Yeah, they go in the pants slot, I guess. Water becomes your friend. I think this allows me to... Water breathe. Okay. I thought it was water walking, but that works too. We got a blue infinity orb, which means pop. Get a blue skill point. We didn't get any water essence, which is kind of a downer. But, nevertheless, we did get some good things. Okay, so, we have two blue points to spend, apparently. Oh, right, I hit level 18 and didn't buy one. Let's see, we got leap, slow fall, slow haste. Haste would be nice, swift swim. Can't really use of that given current alignment. Let's see, place block, feather touch, night vision, binding. You know what, binding wouldn't be bad. We can learn disarm, charm, plow, harvest, grow. Create water is not a bad one. Banish rain is pretty nice. Water breathing. Wow. Yeah, let's go binding. And then I think we'll do. Disarm's not bad. Night vision, invisibility, random teleport, blink. Yeah, I think I want to go this way. Go night vision. Pretty sure there's nothing here I really wanted. A lightning affinity. Well, if I had gone affinity gain boost, we could have gotten past lightning's weakness. I'm pretty sure when you max them out, you get over their weaknesses. Oh well. Alright, what else did I want to do today? We also got a miniature yellow heart. That is something we'll have to deal with later. Yes, that is something more. Have me use it. Alright, so. So, off camera, I'm probably going to build a boss combat structure. So I can do that in the future. A little bit more tactfully build an arena over the entire river. So I do think I need the rainfall to be directly on the river, but I could create like a hole just around the summoning spot and then just bamf out of there. It wouldn't be too hard. I could even set up like a dropper that puts the ritual ingredients into the hole. And then I have a chest that's connected via an item duct to the open crate, and then, yeah. Anyway, what we'll do today, is do I perchance have night orb ready? Found from within a village. No, I do not. Okay. Then I have to move. Just for now. So for now, I'm going to bring this guy down here. And the first thing I'm going to need is I'm going to need a bucket of lava. So let's go find ourselves some lava, shall we? So last time, I think we started on... Last time we started on, what was it? We started on arcane lamps. That's what it was. Arcane lamps, right. So last time we started on arcane lamps, I would like to get those finished for today so that we can keep some stuff from spawning directly around our house. I'll be able to get outside my front door without feeling any risks. So let's go ahead and do that. The only thing we're missing for that recipe is the nitre, which is a Thaumcraft ingredient. For that, I need to use some Thaumcraft alchemy. So, first things first, we need the crucible, which we made at the very end of the last episode as I was signing off, using a wand on a cauldron, just a vanilla cauldron. Place it down, right-click with your wand, doesn't need any viz in it. Just needs to be good to go. So, we had our wand, got our thing, everything is pretty much good to go. So, what we're going to do, we're going to bring this guy downstairs. Put the lava down like so. Now I need some water. And this is only temporary. Once we get the nitre, I'm actually going to use the nitre for the crucible. That way we can not have fires spread to adjacent blocks just at random. Because that tends to happen with lava. So we got ourselves the water now. I think I was pretty quiet during the killing of the boss in that little hole that we dug out, so I might just accelerate through that and then continue on. So it is normal. Alright, so this guy needs to bubble. Now, let's take a look at... Okay, so it's bubbling already. So we need to make ourselves some nitre. So we need glowstone, we've got glowstone. And then we need 3 ignis, 3 lux, and 3 potentia. So we gotta find items that contain those things. Now, first and foremost, we need our glowstone. So I would like to make 2 of these right now. Did we have the recipe for the lamp set out on the table already? We did, and we only have 1. Okay, cool. So, I'm going to make 2 nitre, so I need 6 of each. And that just happens to be the more effective way to do it. So I can use coal, which has 2 potentia and 2 ignis. So that would be horrible if we were trying to make 1, because we would need 3. We can't use 2 of these, we would have 1 too much of each. And then that stuff would just turn into like this goo or gaseous poison nastiness. So, instead, since we're going for 2, we need 6 of each. So I can go ahead and grab 3 of these, and that will give me 6 total. Next thing we're going to need to use is something with lux in it. Do I have any made already? I do, but not enough. So torches, fortunately, have exactly 1 lux to them. So I can just go ahead... grab another piece of coal. Oh. And those things are really hard to see. There we go. We have ourselves 6 torches for 6 lux. They're like super hard to see. Okay. So we're going to go downstairs to the bubbling cauldron. And we're just going to go ahead and dump all of the coal, all of the torches, and all of the glowstone. And that immediately got us exactly what we were after. So, now I can just go ahead. Theoretically, this water shouldn't be here. I'll do. Why not? Alright, so now we can go upstairs, back to where we were previously. So I'm probably going to end up moving to the basement eventually. For now, it serves our purpose. Put the crucible down over the nitre. Put this guy here. And don't really need this lava right now. It is raining again, so I could summon that boss. But that didn't go so well for us last time. Really? What did I hit that? That worked out. So the lava can go in here. Then I'm just gonna go get ourselves our water again. Oop. And the reason I did the alchemy process so quickly was because if you don't act quickly, the compounds will break down. So the Lux would have broken back down into Ignis and air, and then the other ones would have just evaporated. If you wait too long, stuff gets up. So I just go through it very quickly. Alright, so the next thing we're going to need, we might have to pick this up next time. Is we need to charge this wand with Vs. To do that, we're going to need to go fight some mobs or find some aura nodes, which means it might be time to get ourselves some goggles of reveal. But we'll tackle that next time because we are at time for today. So that's going to have to do it for this one. Thank you all for watching. I hope you've enjoyed all that fun stuff. As always, if you did enjoy, please consider leaving a like or a comment. Any and all feedback is always very much appreciated. Helps me out a ton, and I do always love hearing from you guys. And I will see you all in the next episode. Bye for now.